I can be the innkeeper in the nativity play. More sharing. Right, shall we tweet? I think that would be fabulous. What about us tweeting? We always like when we tweet. It's wonderful stuff. Catherine says, you don't need to raise your hand. A man can raise the tone of his voice. That's enough to keep a child in line. Oh, Catherine, absolutely. Do you not remember the great line that mothers used to use? When your dad gets home, the trouble. I'm going to tell dad what you've done. It's wonderful. We love it. I can remember I bought a Jaguar car once, an old one. And I went home with it. And my mother was furious with me. I said, come and see what I've got, Mum. You'll like this. She went out and she looked at her. Oh, yeah, you're an idiot. All that money. And I said, and she went, have you told Dad what you've done? It's as if I'd committed some sort of dreadful crime. I'd bought a Jaguar. Very nice as well. Chocolate brown biscuit hide seats. Catherine, I was more scared of my ma as she battered us. My dad just looked at us. That was enough. Dads did, didn't they? You know? What did I tell you? Now, why did you not do what your mother said? You must be loaded, Scotty, if you don't drink or smoke. No, numpty. Remember, I lost my life savings to a fraudster. So there we are. So no loaded at all. Wise man, no drinking or smoking. A man after my own heart, no either. I have in my time taken a refreshment, and I have in my time smoked. So they are both a pipe, cigarettes, cigars, all these things. But that's 21 years ago gone. And the booze went about 5 years ago, four, 5 years ago, that sort of stuff. Yeah, just couldn't be bothered with it. Because I was trying to work out all that. It's when they brought in the new law in Scotland about how much, what the limit was. And I was trying to calculate it. And I thought, this is impossible. And I thought you could be a teaspoonful over the limit and you become a criminal. They'd take your shoelaces and your tie off you and put you in the slammer for being a teaspoonful over. Do you know what I mean? It's just not worth it. So I just wrapped it in. There we are. And it's quite handy because if somebody needs a run home late at the night, you know, they can say, Scotty, could you take them up the road? Of course I can. I need bother. You know, that sort of idea. Scotty McClure, the voice of the nation, says the wonderful Eddie Doyle. Exactly, when my dad gets home, mind used to say, I won't tell your dad this time. I was convinced my mum could read my mind. What a complex she gave me. I know parents were a bit, they played psychological games with their kids. And I'm not sure it was a good thing at all, Catherine. David Young says, I smoke, only please, I have the now. Only please, only pleasure I have the now. Davy Young, I do not think that sucking 150 toxins into your lung and damaging your air sacs is actually a pleasure. You know what I mean? Giving yourself serious respiratory problems. Good evening, Scotty. Late on tonight, just back in from an outstanding day at Blair Drummond Safari Park. Craig Cochran, how lovely to have you with us. Dinky Doo. Pleasure. You'll have more things to do if the money was in your pocket. Yes, if it was, but it's not, Catherine, for obvious reasons, you know. No, not Mr. Jack Linder. Thanks for passing on good wishes to Anna. Glad your eyes healing well, says Professor Numpty Head. Top man, Numpty Head. So there we go. Scotty, it's to be a scorcher tomorrow. Eddie Doyle, it's roasting in this studio here, I can tell you. Oh, my goodness me, it's absolutely roasty-posty. Roasty-posty-toasty. Professor Numpty Head, are you Mr. Jack? Oh, my goodness. I'm on the vape now.